whenever you are in long phase, remember this. Vivekananda says, whenever you are in a depressed mood with a long phase, lock yourself in the room. You have no right to spread sorrow or sadness in the life, in the world, in the society. You have no right to spread depression or the sorrow in the world. There are enough of people who are depressed. There is enough of depression. There is enough of sorrow in the world. You have no right to add something more. Whenever you are dull, dead, depressed, lock yourself in the room. Then all of us has to be in the room throughout the day. Whenever you come out, as you wear the dress, wear a smile, wear a dancing mood, bubbling joy. And don't tell, I have seen many people, I don't feel, how can I express, Swamiji? When you express only, you start experiencing. Expression and experience go hand in hand. Start expressing, you will start seeing, you will start experiencing. Don't wait for the experience to happen, then you will express. Express, then you will see, experience happens. You wait for the experience. Whatever experience comes, you know how to make it as a ori. Anything you can see, you can make it as a ori. Because you have mastered the art. You mastered the art, a small story. A man was sitting outside his house and weeping and wailing very badly. His friend came and inquired, what happened, what happened? Why are you weeping so much? He said, no, no, just 3 days ago, my grandfather passed away, writing a will, leaving a will, all his properties to me. The man said, what is wrong in it? You yourself 60, your grandfather must have been above 100. It is too late. Yes, come on, okay, no problem. I know your grandfather, he had a lot of properties. And you got the properties, you should be happy. You should be joyful. No, 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 you don't know. 1 month ago, my uncle also passed away, leaving all his properties to me. Perfectly all right. I know your uncle. He also must be above 80. And he also had millions of dollars. Now you are rich. Why are you bothering so much about it? No, 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 you don't know. 3 months ago, my grandmother passed away, leaving all her properties. This man thought, really, whether he has gone crazy or what? 3 relatives leaving their properties and passing away. It's a moment to be celebrated. Then he started advising, are you really sensitive? You feel lonely because they've all died? What is happening? What is the reason? At least tell me the reason. You can, by telling, sharing your dukkha, sharing your sorrow, you can be relaxed. He said, no, no, that is not my problem. You don't understand. Now I have no more relatives who will leave their properties and die. I have nobody else who will give their properties and die. How much you get, your mind asks, what next? What next? What next? You take everything as a your birthright. Till you get the properties of your father, you think when it will come, when it will come. When it comes, you take that as a birthright. Then you start thinking, the neighbors. What next? Because you mastered the art of worrying, anything, you can make it as a worry. So, there's a saying, before you get even the mustard seed looks like a mountain. Once you attain, achieve, even the mountain looks like a mustard seed. When it is in your garage, even the mountain looks like a mustard seed. That's what is the mind. So never think, expect that joy will come from inside, then you will jump around or move around. Now itself, make your being alive. carry a smile with you always. It's not for the sake of somebody else I'm telling you, it's for the sake of you. When you smile, don't think somebody else is going to have some benefit. No, it is you who are going to have the benefit. When you are in the blissful mood, don't think somebody else is going to have some benefit from you. No, it is you who is going to live your life. So expand the fifth layer of your being. Anandam brahmedi navyajana. Ananda is God. Don't miss it by not having it. Don't waste it by not enjoying it. It is there in your life. Just small, small expressions. In our ashram, we have a habit. If somebody drops anything, if somebody breaks anything, we immediately say thank you. We immediately shout thanks. See, the dropping or breaking, nobody is going to do purposely. If somebody drops, we can make the whole scene mess, shouting at them. Fool, don't you have brain? If he has got brain, why will he marry you? Why will he come and live with you? You can make the whole scene mess also. And the same way you can make the whole scene joyful also. Nobody is going to drop anything or break anything purposely. It is already dropped, now nothing can be done. If you shout also, nothing can be done. If you weep also, nothing can be done. It's happened. Now, it is up to you whether to handle the moment joyfully and take it lightly, or whether to make it as a reason to shout at others. You see, we are just inside, we are carrying a big welcome of suppressed emotions. So we are just waiting to catch some reason to jump on somebody. Only you want small reasons. You don't need much big reasons. Small reasons are enough to jump on the people. A small example. Once a lion was just trying to catch the deer and it has caught and is about to kill. The deer shouted, "Oh, what have I done? I have not done any mistake. Why are you killing me?" Lion told, "What? You have not done any mistake. I was about to drink the water in the lake. The lake water. You entered to the lake and made the whole thing muddy. I am not able to drink it." "No, no, no, you know the truth. I have not even entered inside the lake. I am just outside. How can you tell such a big lie?" "No, no. You have seen your face in that. When you saw your face, you may not put your mouth inside the water. But you have seen your face in that lake. That itself made the lake muddy." "No, no. Tell me the truth. I have not even gone near the lake. Why are you telling such big lie? Please, I have not even gone near the lake. How can you say, how can you make me the reason for the muddy lake?" "No, you may not have done, but your forefathers must have done. Your father must have done. Your mother must have done. That's why the lake is muddy. Otherwise, how can this lake become muddy?" See, so to jump on others, you can find any reason. You can find any reason. This is the way in our life. We are just bubbling. We want to miss the reasons to jump on others. Never, never, never do that. Carry a live mood, an alive being within you. You will see, you can expand all the five layers. And your small I can become big I. Your Mithyananda can become Nityananda. Your suffering, a dukkha, can become eternal bliss. So carry these few ideas, these few understandings in your life. Then you will see your small I, which creates continuous problem, becomes a big I, which creates continuous bliss. The I problem will disappear. The I problem will simply not only be solved, it will be dissolved into the eternal bliss. Let you enter, be in, and become eternal bliss, Jnananda.